Hello viewers, welcome to Elimu TV, whereby we are going to learn and experience together. Today we are going to have our biology form 2 lesson 20, whereby your tutor will be me, Mr. Gerard. We are going to handle the topic on gaseous exchange, and the subtopic gaseous exchange in animals. Before we get into our topic, we can have the following lesson goal, whereby by the end of the lesson, you should be able to give the characteristics of respiratory services in animals. So let us begin on the lesson, and you're welcome. So now we are having characteristics of respiratory services, and here we are first dealing with the characteristics of respiratory animals, whereby we are dealing the characteristics of respiratory services, whereby we are being interested in animals. We can say various types of respiratory services have been developed by different animals to facilitate gaseous exchange depending on the animal size, activity, and the environment in which it operates. The respiratory service is the basic unit of any breathing system upon which gaseous exchange takes place by diffusion. However, the respiratory service must meet the condition, must meet some certain conditions. One of the conditions is that a respiratory service, it must have a very large service area, as you can see. Two, a respiratory service must be moist. Three, a respiratory service, it should have a large capillary of network. And lastly, it must have a thin lining. These characteristics you can see from our screen, they constitute the characteristics of most respiratory services. Now we are going deep into, because these are now the general characteristics of animals, I would like us now we go to a specific animal, whereby we are going to look at the protozoan, whereby we shall be specific on the amoeba. We can say amoeba, which is a member of the kingdom Protoctista, it is used to present the protozoa. The amoeba is a single-celled aquatic organism whose entire body surface is always in contact with the surrounding water. We have a diagrammatic representation of an amoeba species in our screen. The organism is small and has a large surface area exposed to its aquatic environment. It therefore does not need an elaborate gaseous exchange system, since its gaseous exchange needs can be adequately met by diffusion across its cell membrane. Oxygen dissolved in the surrounding water diffuses across the membrane into the cytoplasm. In a similar manner, carbon dioxide and other soluble waste diffuse out through the membrane into the surrounding water along a concentration gradient. Now we have looked at the diffusion gaseous exchange in protozoans. Specifically, we are dealing with the amoeba. I would like us now we look on the gaseous exchange in insects. Remember, insects belong to kingdom Insecta, and we can say as you are aware that insects are generally small animals. The small size is quite advantageous to the animal in terms of gaseous exchange, since their surface area to volume ratio is large. However, being larger than the amoeba, there is need for the development of a breathing system. This system is made up of large network of air tubes known as the tracheal system. As you can see from our screen, from our diagram, we have the tracheas there. The system penetrates into all parts of the body to improve on the efficiency of the gaseous exchange. Our screen shows the tracheal system of a grasshopper. We have just taken an example of an insect, whereby I have just decided to use the grasshopper to show one of the insects. The tracheal system of an insect, which forms its breathing system, consists of the spiracles, as you can see from our diagram, the trachea, and we also have the tracheals. Spiracles are external openings present on either side of the abdomen and thorax of an insect through which air from the atmosphere enters the body. Each spiracle is supplied with a muscular valve that controls its opening. and also with ears to prevent excessive loss of water from the tissues by evaporation. The spiracles then open into large tubes known as the trachea, whereby you are able to see the trachea from our diagram, which are arranged in definite patterns and penetrate the whole body space of an insect. These air tubes are reinforced with spiral bands of chitin to keep them open. The trachea then subdivides into finer air tubes known as the tracheals, which ramify the body tissues of the animal for direct supply to individual cells. Since the tracheals lack the spiral bands of chitin, they permit gaseous exchange across their thin, moist walls. Having done and said that, we can have the following activity whereby you are required to describe the gaseous exchange in protozoans. You can just take an example of any protozoan. Why? Because in our lesson we took a protozoan whereby we were represented by the amoeba, and you also described the gaseous exchange in insects, whereby in our lesson this insect over here. So in our activity, you should describe the gaseous exchange in any protozoan and insects. Just take an insect and you describe it. Having done and said that, we can refer to KLB, Secondary Biology Students Book 1, which is the 4th edition, Nairobi, Kenya Literature Bureau. For this lesson and many more of our biology lessons, you can send us an SMS through the number that is appearing on our screen, or you subscribe to our YouTube channel, which is Elimu TV, or our Facebook page, which is also Elimu TV, or you tweet us at Elimu TV _Kenya. Thanks for watching, and let us subscribe so that we may have many more of our lessons. You're welcome.